big trust. It's been done, no? In the past, there's this idea of this sense of lightness. It's all using screws. It can be easily replaced, recycled, reused. And there's this scenario, no? From tectonics, from bricks, to this lightness. And here I'd like to show you, this is Alejandro de la Sota in Madrid. This is Maravillas gym. I was here being 22 years old with the architect, with Alejandro, okay? So I was here with him walking, and he was saying, you know, I have all the children doing the classrooms are here, and we are playing sports here, and they are upstairs. The whole thing is fully, the program is full into the structure. Therefore, I think it's very important you come to the Mediatik, or you go to the Eden project, or that you do experience architecture to have knowledge. Do experience, full experience, to create knowledge. Okay, it's an experience to be in this school. Therefore, there will be knowledge. But if there isn't an experience, an experience that really changes you, there will not be knowledge. So this is the structure. We have the program inside. This is kind of this metaphysic space somehow, that the lights, the false ceiling, it's all mashing. There's no in, there's no out. There's this scenario of transparency, very parametric, very driven, very... That's another story. Virilio talks that when he goes to cathedrals, he does this to cathedrals. He hacks the cathedral. Have you heard of this? He hacks the cathedral, and then he listens. And of course, he listens 2,000 tons of stone working. Yes? So it's a bit... Pretty empty, this one. Not performing a thing. So, architecture performs, you know? When you go to a cathedral and you hack, the thing is, wow, it's fully, fully charged. It's doing, it's working, okay? It's not this kind of still image. So people go here, we wanted them to be able to hack. So people, they do this, no? They hack here and they say, yes, yes, I feel it. And I said, yeah, it's a good feeling, but it's like this. It's coming up. So this is it, no? It's a building that comes up, no? All the weight is collected and it comes up. So you have seen these beautiful airports where the weight is collected down into this kind of forest, into this kind of trees, but here is going up. Therefore, it's very thin. In this office building, and this is how the offices are laid out, the thickness of the leg of the table is the same thickness as the structure of the building. The leg of the table and it's kind of the same family, brothers and sisters. And this is what it performs. It creates this empty lobby with no structure, no columns. And we have tested this with children. They go in after going through the entrance. They go in and they see and they look and they all say, something is missing. But really children, no? Like, something is missing. And okay. So it's good. Something is missing. Sometimes we have to design that there is things missing. It's more what we take out than what we put. So that's kind of the lobby. These photos are by Ivan Van. He came quick. We are against this. Okay, David Chipperfield, but now is Mr. Foster. We are against this. This is a centralized solution. This is a cross. When this collapse, the building collapse. It's centralized. Okay. We have been in a geopolitical scenario where things were centralized, centralized government, centralized language, centralized countries, centralized borders, and we have to move to biosphere politics where it is all distributed, distributed, distributed thinking. So we are, you follow me? One computer, distributed computers. One hub, distributed hubs. One IP address, millions of IP addresses. That's distributed, okay? So our structure is a distributed structure. If this bar collapses, the network readjusts for this bar. They all work. This is why Obama won the elections, because he worked distributed, distributed, distributed. Not centralized, not lobby oriented, but rather distributed oriented. And here you have a lot to say. You as students, as a staff, as people, we have to go into this distributed thinking. This structure is 120 bars, so they all have different thickness. Normally engineers, they calculate for the peak of the structure, so that's the peak, so that's the worst scenario, so all the structure performs for that peak, so that's centralized. We do one calculation and we build based on one calculation. Instead, there is the distributed calculation, which is to go bar by bar and calculate each of the strengths on each bar. A lot of time, a lot of fee, a good fee for the architects and for the engineers. Where is the money? In the kilos of steel? No, in the knowledge, in us. Where is the money? In us. Okay? This was 25% reduction on steel. 25% reduction on steel. Okay? Same contract, less steel, more complexity. So distributed, distributed thinking. The distributed creates complexity. We all know that distributed complexities creates emergency, emergent elements like this. We call these flowers. And the good news, the good news is that in Catalonia there is over 60 digital manufacturing places where they do steel, glass, wood, plates, furniture, structure, ceramics. There is 60 digital places. You know, when we found this one, we were like, well, we're not going to say anything to the rest of the architects, right? It's like, I found the source. It's my source. My treasure, no? It's my treasure. But the good news is that there is 60 places. And of course, in Barcelona, there isn't 60 digital architects ready to plot to these places. But I hope in this school, there is 600 digital architects ready to plot. Therefore, the industry of construction, they have done the homework. They are ready. Architects, we might not be ready. Or yes, we are ready. The good news, they are ready. Okay? In this factory, there is 15 people running robots on the factory level and 25 engineers sending data to these robots. Okay? Remember the scenario here? The centralized scenario, 5 engineers, 100 people working, hand working. This scenario, only 5 people taking care of the robots, 25 engineers running knowledge. Okay? Distributed. Centralized, distributed. Distributed is a key word. So the structure is like this. These are the flowers. We have built all the flowers. They are all different and so on, so on. What we have done is this idea of public awareness. Today there was a very interesting sentence about not doing public space but transparent space. No, this idea, for instance, here we are not doing a collage of bars. This is not my drawing. This is the wing diagram of forces against the glass elevation. Against the glass elevation, we have these wind forces that reach as a diagram of energy, of tension, and this is exactly what we have built. So people see the building and they see the diagram of forces. So that's kind of teaching. It's a teaching, education, transferring knowledge architecture. And this is also very important. There are these moments in this, what we learn about managing this building is that we were the youngest architects in the competition, the highest fee in the competition, and everybody was like, well, this Enric, oh my God, it's not going to happen. It's not going to end well. No? It's like your first building in Barcelona, young architect. So what we did was to build this model. It's a steel model. It's a steel model for a steel structure. So we show them, and there was this presence that, well, if this is what, this became the boss, not the architect, but this object became the presence of what to do. And when there is a presence, there is a certain push towards it. The other thing we wanted to do was this idea of fiction, this idea of jellyfish, this idea of bioluminescent. Jellyfish, as you may know, it's not an animal, it's a system. Inside there is a few animals, there is few hearts, there is a few minds living inside, okay? It's a system, it's a home. So this is what we've done to the structure. We have not used After Effects, no Photoshop, and we did this before Avatar. Okay, that's important. The dating is important. It's true, eh? This is a video, a constant video, that when you turn off the lights of the building, that's what happens. The bioluminescent paint is based on a mineral, which is a natural performance. And it's applied to the structure, so we don't have light by night to light the building. The building lights by itself during 6 hours with this brightness. What we want to say here is that the city is too bright, and we are sending a very strong message to this idea of global warming. Imagine the parking in front of the Media-ICT building. Something got wrong in the 80s, and we have to stop it. It's weird, no, to see cars being light during the whole night. We are very used to this image, no, and why not? But cars, they have light, no? They have their own light. And we, as a city, we have to light them against thieves, or against what? We cannot do this. We cannot waste energy in this concept of lighting. I mean, the neighbors, they don't get enough darkness. They have to close the windows. They cannot see the moon. Nobody can sleep. The city is too bright, as you see here, no? At this time, no? So we are using robots. This is the Bremen factory, the vector voltage factory in Bremen. We scan the structure in Barcelona, a 3D plot that came to the office. We design all the cushions. We send the cushions here to London, to Victor Foltic Engineering. They did the calculation, send us back the air pressure, and we always kept the design with us, and we were the ones sending the plot files to the factory in Bremen. But that's very important, you know. Before, the architect was doing plans for a builder, which was doing plans for a glass maker, who was doing plans for a ETFE maker, who was sending plans to the machines. Your plan and the machine, there were like 7 other plans on the way. Instead, we have to be the center of this distributed knowledge. Therefore, all the knowledge gets to our plan, but we have the responsibility to plot the fabrication file, okay? If this happens in industry, it's really strong. It's really strong. We lose all the intermediators in between, okay? So that's how we work with these robots to lift the structure. Now you're going to see the video. These are these moments where the TV is on site and they have to film and so on. And these are these, it's software driven, and it's 8 engines, and each one can carry 800 tons. Okay, so we lift it up in 1.5 days. So instead of building 3 floors with a secondary steel structure and then do the floors, we work at the base with no problems of security. And then in 1 day, for months, we work for months at the floor level. And then in 1 day, we move it up. We got this award from the European steel companies. And this is the structure that was targeted by this. This is the ETFE cushions at the on-site level. Instead of doing this with glass, we did it with ETFE, which is very light, which can do surfaces of 6 meters by 9 meters with no joints. This was a group of 8 people doing this for a month. So again, cheap, light, performative, strong, and the glass industry is kind of trembling against this. We were able to do a double skin with this. That's kind of the double skin, the balconies, the program. Looking at energy levels, that's very crucial, very important, because in energy we have arrived to the levels that in Barcelona, the south versus the north is about 6,000 watts hour versus 2,000. So north versus south, 2,000, 6,000. So 3 times more, 300% more. And we all know that in terms of economy, we would like England, United Kingdom, to improve its economy 2%. And we would love if Spain grows 1%. And China is rocking 10%. And in energy, we are not considering 300%. Okay? So these are the levels of energy that we need to achieve, that we can perform. So each energy diagram, one skin, like this Gaudí scenario, where the program is inside and merges outside. And this is the new code of construction, which is telling us we need a sunshade of 0.45. If we do this, we reduce the CO2 emissions by 15%. The new code of construction is okay, it's interesting, but it doesn't have the ambition enough to put us where we want. As you well remember, in the Copenhagen global warming meeting, we were asking the countries to sign on a 20% reduction. And they didn't. The new code is telling us to achieve a 15%. That's the law, but it's not enough. So we as an office decided to perform 4 times the new code, okay, from 0.45 to 0.10. In energy performance, we want to reduce the air conditioning. 80% of the energy in the Mediterranean is used in air conditioning. So to achieve that, 15% is the new code, but we decided to do this patent. this new research on a double skin. This is the glass. These are the cushions, three foils. I'm performing foils, moving foils. Therefore, there's a black box, and each cushion moves the inner layer. That's the kind of a double skin, glass and cushions. And this is what it does. The middle layer moves back and closes the cushion. So when the cushion is open, that's 0.45. And when the cushion closes, performs four times more. Therefore, 60% reduction on CO2 emissions. That's a 36% performance. That's the cushion on the southwest facade, which is a vertical cushion. We are crazy again, no? In the 80s. People were designing buildings at discomfort levels and then using energy to bring them to comfort levels. Why don't we design buildings at comfort levels already, and we don't need energy to get back to it, to get back to comfort levels? So you well know this. This is an excellent project, Nicholas Grimshaw, the Eden project in Cornwall. If you haven't been there, please go. I think it's one of these experiences that really produces knowledge. Who has been there? One, two, three, four, five? You two? Yes, yes, yes. That's interesting. In this place, they grow plants with the coffee trees, and you are able to have a coffee and then see how many plants is needed for that coffee. That gives you this kind of sense. The Allianz Arena in Munich, which is an ETFE membrane, it's an ETFE building, it's an icon building, it's not an energy-driven ETFE membrane. That's the Beijing building, as you know. It's half energy-driven, but the other half is very icon, media-oriented. This is our building, which is 90, 100% energy-driven. That's the building. And here, we wanted to do two technologies because the energy is very different in southeast and southwest. So in these big cushions, these vertical cushions, which are 36 meters up, but it's one chamber, we wanted to perform a fog system. So we have created this video to show this to Vector Foil Tech. Thank you. So this is the prototype in Bremen. It's a nitrogen-based fog. Here you see, this is the sensor of light emission to sense how much light is passing by the fog, through the fog. These are some pressure sensors in terms of fog. This is Cal. It's a mess. And he's happy. So for a German to be happy, it means it works. So we were very happy about it. We did water jet. We worked with Urs from MIFOC, the same people who did the cloud of in Iberdrolon, the Direct Ofidio cloud. We worked with CO. Kind of the fog performing. Here you see that's kind of the transparent moment. It takes 30 minutes, so these are kind of accelerated movies. But here you see the corner here. It starts by this corner. So it goes from that to that. That's the full membrane. And these are photos of this last summer performance. So the building creates a vertical cloud to achieve this 0.10. And this explains very well, no? This idea of brick tectonics, therefore particles. It's all about particles, membranes, as the work of our unit 18. That's kind of the double skin. This is from the inside. This is the system, the nitrogen base. Is particle based. The particle, 80% of the particle is nitrogen and 20% is natural oil. It's a transparent natural oil. This is the system. Of course, it's a circuit, so we are injecting the fog, but at the same time we do have to, after 3 hours, take it out and filter the fog. That's the other system. This is the diaphragma system. What we are doing here is that we are applying smart intelligence to this. Let me explain you a few of the sensors we have. We have these motion sensors and the logo. I'll show you a small movie with a lot of humor. Instead of having a lobby that lights on or off, this idea of distributed intelligence, there is a grid. that's kind of the interaction we are looking for. Okay, the automation, this also reduces 25% of the consumption on power. We have a sensors that they read the first 3 meters. I mean, it's a very typical image in probably London as well, at least in Barcelona. We have this beautiful day, lot of sun, a glass facade, and all the fluorescent lighting all the way to the facade on. And it's like, what happens? What did we do wrong? So there's not enough sensing. These sensors, they stop the first 3 meters, they don't turn on. If there is 500 luxes that is enough to work, that's by law, the space will not light, will not light. As architects, we are not delivering the building and going away. We have a contract to stay for a year doing monitoring. Monitoring is crucial. Engineers, they don't do a car and then they don't do a couple of tours, no? Or they don't drive it. Of course they drive it. They want to know, to sense it. So we as architects, we have to stay in the place, sense it, deliver, certificate. And that's kind of the sensors along. And this is, we are very happy about this, that you are also working in your models with Arduino platforms. So what we wanted to do here was a distributed intelligence membrane. Therefore, 104 cushions will have 104 sensors, each cushion its own sensor. Therefore, a computer, an Arduino platform for that sensor to be applied the performance to that cushion. And that's what we are doing. This is the Arduino Pro that is inside a black box that moves the cushion, opening and closing one by one. So not centralized, as a centralized decision from the top building all the way down, so the whole building closes or opens, but rather distributed thinking, as this video shows. So when we have a shadow of the building nearby performing here, these cushions open or close, and when there's a shadow of the building here coming and closing, they do perform. They perform individually. Okay? Is it understood? Okay. So that's the skin, the performative skin. Here you see that's a sensor, it's a luxometer, that sensor is this cushion. That sensor is this cushion, that one, that one, that one. 104 sensors, 104 cushions, 104 Arduino platforms performing daily, every day, every hour, every moment in this skin. We are looking at other buildings that they have this performative and this kind of platforms of Arduino computers, and but we haven't found. So I think it's a very unique building for these reasons. And these are all the test beds, the laboratory research on this idea of performing a landscape. It's a landscape from the building to the city of Barcelona. They perform other things like opening and closing and so on. We got this award from the Catalan government on ETFE, and this is the real award. And the real award is that the Ministry of Industry checks the building, checks the energy efficiency, and delivers a category. I haven't seen here at the AA, but at the Bartlett, when you go in, you see this certificate, and in all public buildings in Europe, they must have this as a certificate. So you are, Bartlett is E. I don't know this building, probably is E or F. No, I heard that might get to G in the next few months. After the work in July, we'll be around here. So, look guys, you know WikiLeaks, yes, no? WikiLeaks made everybody transparent. This is it, no? This is what we are, boom, bam. Internet made reality transparent. I can destroy this school with a couple of emails sending what's the status of this building, or you say it. Seriously, seriously. So the ministry gave us an A, and there is 2 buildings in Spain, and there is 6 buildings in Europe with this A. This means 70% reduction on CO2 emissions. Okay? Net buildings are 90%. The building performs 90% CO2 reduction. So a zero emission building is 100. So this 92 performance that we have is getting there. Okay? And you are students that the law, I mean, the European community, I mean, the people at the unit, they know this agenda 2020, and by for sure, we know now that the new code of construction, which is going to be out in 2019, is 8 years from now, is asking that any new building will be zero emission building. So Media-ICT is a leading building in 8 years. It's everybody performing like this. Okay, so we are not so weird because in 8 years, everybody has to perform A. Okay, so the industry of cars, they are doing their homework, and I'm not sure architecture is doing their homework. Okay. The electric car was killed. You might have seen the movie, no? Who killed the electric car? But the electric car also comes very fast. No, it's 2028. No, it's 2018. No, it's 2015. No, it's 2013. Yeah, now it's 2012. Excuse me, it's next year. So the acceleration of industry in global warming numbers, architecture is number one cause of global warming. We emit 40% of the CO2 emissions. Cities consume 80% of the energy. We, as architects and urban designers, we have the key of global warming. So we have to be responsible to that. We are the problem, and we might be the solution. Yes, we are the solution. Yeah, we are the problem, yes, but we are the solution. So being the solution is leadership, but responsible because we are the problem. Cars are number third cause. They emit 20% on the CO2 emissions. So the car industry is doing the homework, and the architecture field, I feel, is not doing the homework. That's why Brett invited me to be here to set this green agenda in the, at the AA school with this kind of leadership, but also responsible situation. And the last good news about this building is the cost. 1,200 euros a square meter is a market price. My client is the mayor's office. And when they came to us, they said, well, you know, as public buildings, we have 2,500 euros a square meter. I said, yeah, but that makes it unique. So the day of the opening, people will say, it's a unique building. And I will say, but we don't want to be unique. We want transversality. We want distributed power, green distributed power, this green new agenda. So we said, what's the market cost? Give me the same budget as all the buildings in the first photo. Give me the same market price. And that's what we got. So the building is 90% CO2 emissions performance with the same market cost as the other buildings. So it's saying, excuse me, money is not the excuse not to do sustainable design. It's not the excuse. There's another one, but not that one. And just to finish, this is people like Kevin Roach in New York. They have done these fantastic new typologies of how the program is applied to the building. And this is how we use parametric design. Yes, we do parametric design, but how we do it. These are CAD files from plans of the building, the different scenarios and configurations. And these are Excel files. So they are linked. Whatever we change in the CAD file is applied to these numbers. And these numbers are natural light, cycle of materials, economy, and a very important one for us, which is the impact of the vertical communication in the program spread in the building. Normally, this ratio is 18-20%. In our building, is 8%. So the computer, if we put these numbers here, the computers were looking for less stairs, less elevators, less distance, fire escapes, less configurations, and we got to a very weird plan, which is this one, where we have one stair there, one stair here, they are in the skin, they are not in the core, they are not symmetric, they have this shift, but the distance is exactly 36 meters, which is exactly the fire escape. If the building will be another extra meter, we will need a third stairs. The distance that there is a one elevator here, but then there is three elevators there, the situation of the toilets and so on. When we went to the client with this configuration typology, they were, look guys, you are nuts or what? You don't know that everything is in the core, it's in the center, the core, no? Excuse me, everybody knows this, no? Come on, psst, bam, taka, 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 taka. Look, okay, good, we did it. Look, you see what happens? Boom, yeah, in the core, you see the core? That's the core, no? Taka, 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 okay, in the core. 18% of communication versus program. In this scenario, 8%. So we have liberated 10% of 20,000 square meters, 2,000 square meters. We have created a new floor, empty, for the program. And of course, there is trust. You know, we have a society that will judge us because of numbers. Bad news or good news, but we will be judged by the economy, how much extra budget we deliver. We close the construction in a minus 1% budget related to real cost. Okay, so we as green architects or young architects or not experienced architects, we deliver a process of a building which was on these numbers. Okay, we are very proud of saying that and sharing that with all of you. So this is kind of the scenario, and we have created this book with the publisher, Aktar Birhauser. This is the prototype of the book. It's going to be out very soon, and it will be here at the library. So watch for that. We produce patents to share patents. We produce patents not to protect us against the market. No, no, we produce patents because it's a certificate that we do innovation, but then we share it. In this book, you will see all this in a share open source platform, okay? And in reality, buildings are becoming this. Buildings are becoming these massive systems where we have been using geothermal. This is a geothermal scenario where the infrastructure is water that goes to the sea in Barcelona and comes back cold, so it's cold water that is put in all our air conditioning devices. Therefore, you are inside your office and you look to the sea and you know that that sea is producing cold energy that comes inside the building that is sent through the air conditioning to my table, and that is the empathy Jeremy Rifkin is talking about. Empathy, meaning being linked to the sea, that puts you in harmony, in balance with this idea of nature, of sources, of energy. But for that, we need high, sophisticated, balanced, complex systems. The good news is that this school is known for this, for complexity, for ecology, strong, technologically driven, digitally making. So you have the language and the platform to do these systems. I just want you that your numbers are green. That's a little shift, but it's important that they are empathic. So that's kind of the book, and this is a little bit like the last image on the Media-ICT. If I do have five more minutes, I'm going to close with another quick example for the unit. Is that okay? Yes, okay? Yes. This was a good finish, eh? Boom. No, okay. Okay, so so we have proof that we can do buildings which are green and so on. We have to go to another level of discussion and research. This is San Sebastian. It's the city of San Sebastian. And they, we got a very weird phone call, again, like the, my mother. And this time was the mayor's office saying, we would like you to do a site-specific work in this city, and by doing that, we will get a lot of attention in the newspapers and in the news, on TV, and so on. Excuse me? Yeah, it's called city marketing. Yeah, go on, explain more, what is it? And then they said, yeah, instead of investing in doing photos of the city and paying newspapers to have our city, come and live in San Sebastian, visit San Sebastian. Instead of that, they take that money into a project of architecture that creates a debate, that creates an event, that creates knowledge, that creates added value. Therefore, media is very much looking for that. Okay? So that puts you on the front cover, that puts you on the news and so on. I found it interesting or weird. So I was attending this first meeting. So I said to them, look, in this city you have a fantastic source of energy, which is the sea, the ocean of San Sebastian. You have fantastic waves. Waves is in your culture. Waves is in your empathy. And waves is something that we could work with. I'm not going to do an installation in your city, but rather do an installation over the waves, about waves, in empathy with waves. So we start as waves. Here there is sound. These are creative waves. These waves is impossible. Into two directions, this wave creates an inside space. So it's about particles, when we like to talk about and to define and to sense reality, we always go into particles. So this is a fantastic wave that does the space, that comes back, that creates a second skin, that wraps the building, it is a building, it's particles, and so on. So this kind of digital wave, but performative, driven by weight. We said to them, look, we would like very much to address this issue. Fiberglass structure with distributed intelligence and contents and connected to an engine, to a machine that produces energy. So we did all the research in terms of what machines produce energy. I think this is also a lot of the work of the unit, this kind of approach. So this is hydroflood. It's a very interesting, sensible system that produces energy out of waves. So when the waves are 6 meters high, they have these cables attached to the bottom of the sea, and the whole thing goes down into the water to be protected against the big waves. But at the same time, any little wave, any little vibration produces energy. It's a Spanish patent, and it has these prototypes. We discussed with Greenpeace about collaborating in this project, and they offer to do so by changing the fish market by the energy market. Okay, so instead of seeing boats going to the sea to fish and then bring fish back to the market, the boat was going to this power plant, collecting energy with hydrogen batteries, fuel cell batteries, and bringing the energy back to the town. So I'm going to fish energy and I come back with energy. That's kind of the paradigm now on this market. So we work with Jeremy into this and so on. Of course, there's this idea of Leonardo, of these parametric also drawings and particle driven. So we decided that a wave is created by one line that connects to the next one, to the next one, the next frame, the next frame. So the whole structure will explain, will show, will perform the evolution of a wave. This is the So if we take this material and then we do a base, a structure, then we work with BOMA of how this fiberglass structure has to be, has to perform, which bars they do, they work, they don't work. What's good about fiberglass is that it's in constant movement. So the wave is in constant movement, the wind is in constant movement, and the bars are in constant movement. It's this kind of kinetic structure, sculpture. And we did all the planning on how is the foundation. It's a steel foundation that can be taken away later on, so not to reduce or to kill biological landscape, deep water landscape. And we work with this idea that there will be sensors and the content of music, internet, graphics, and so on will be applied to this. So it's a kind of a grid that has a structure, that has nozzles. There's one nozzle every 50 centimeters. So 9,000 nozzles, 9,000 IP addresses to perform. This is the network distributed. And you could perform here. One kid comes to the bar and receives this water while the cloud is creating the wave is creating this cloud, and that follows the music and the sound of the sea. Or we have the Red Cross Day, which the wave performs, or so on. So it's in their culture. San Sebastian has this deep culture with the beach, and it will create this moment, this gathering together, this democratic space, this scenario, this discussion. This is the model. So it's filled with the steam from the sea. When the sea is very brave, the wave is also very brave. The more energy I produce, the more energy I consume, so I stay in balance. If the sea is not so brave, the wave is calm, is cool, is waiting for energy. So it's fully connected. The worse it gets, the worse its performance. It has the same height as the Moneo Cursal building. So it's kind of this presence, this architecture. It gathers 1,000 people inside, and people do this. They walk through the beach, and they move in inside of it to learn, to listen, to feel empathy. Questions? Would you like some feedback?
Yeah.
Are we the only ones in the school? That the school belongs to us at this moment?
Yeah, I would like to ask a couple of questions about the Bouilly Foundation project.
Yes.
Firstly, its ambitions regarding the emissions, CO2 emissions. Does it aim to go below 0% and trap emissions? I was reading somewhere in the blog about using seaweed.
Because we are in a natural park, we want that the same way as Ferran Adrià is leading in terms of cuisine and kitchen, that we do produce power, positive power for that. And we are going to use different technologies. I'm going to explain this project in another time, but not today. But we are very much looking forward.
Secondly, this concept of distributive architecture or even particle architecture seems to be in form itself is quite fluid. And it seems like in each project it adapts to the maybe context or to the new ideas that you develop about this architecture. I was wondering, for the Bouilly Foundation, what form is taking right now this concept of particle?